Inner Sanctum Mystery, brought to you by the makers of Cottage Pills.
Good evening, friends. I'm Raymond Gerhold. Remember? Won't you come in to our inner sanctum?
Yeah, it's very gratifying that you have the courage to come back. I was afraid our story last week might have been too much for you. But since it wasn't, suppose we see what you think of tonight's tale. The story of a strange, weird voyage that makes the ancient mariner look like one of the rover boys. Dinner Sanctum Mystery tonight bring you The Death Ship, featuring an all-star cast of radio favorites in an original radio drama by Robert Newman. Presented for your entertainment by the makers of Carter's Little Liver Pills, the best friend to your sunny disposition.
Now, wait. A question before we begin. Do you really know anything about the sea? The sea that covers two-thirds of the Earth's surface? It's a place of storms and sudden death. A place where anything can happen, and usually does, aboard the death ship. The Caribbean, vast blue home of the Gulf Stream and the mysterious Sargasso Wild. Somewhere near its center, heading north, an open boat. In it, their eyes red-rimmed, their faces raw and cracked, are five men. One of them glances astern. There, trailing them, is a menacing, triangular, black skin.
Captain Pike.
Aye. What is it, Carter?
He's back. He's following us again.
Oh, hey.
That shark. The same one that picked us up right after the wreck.
How do you know it's the same one?
Because I do, and I don't like it. You know what it means. He smashed death. He'll keep on following us until... I'll hold the torch, Captain. You can't get him.
Ah, what's the thing? I tried three times already.
But please, Captain. Look, give me your gun and let me try.
Okay.
Hold it, Dillard.
Did you get him?
Never even flinched.
Maybe he'll go away when Josh dies. That's what he's waiting for.
Yes, he isn't going to die. He isn't.
With all his ribs dove in? Okay.
He's breathing easier all the time. Because, look, he's opening his eyes.
Water. Water.
He's asking for water.
I heard him.
Aren't you going to give him any?
Don't be a fool, friend. You know he's dying. Water won't save him. There's hardly enough for the rest of us.
He's entitled to his share, sir. He can have my ration besides.
Mine, too.
Well, for my money, you're crazy, but... All right, Corky, force him out. Hurry up a cup.
Okay, Captain. I think you're not too, Benson. But here you go.
Thanks. There you are, Josh. There you are. Now drink this.
Water. Good. Where am I? What happened?
Don't you remember, Josh? The Mary Kay. That storm last night.
Oh.
We ran into a reef off Skeleton Key. Found it. All hands were lost except us. Some gear fell on you and you got kind of hurt.
Skeleton Key? I remember. My ticket to leave. After the pipe told me we were clear of the reef, the strange ass caught. I did. And then we... You know, Captain Pike, you wanted to wreck the ship.
What? You're crazy.
You did. Piled it up for your insurance. And Corporal was in it with you. You had the launch caught out before we even struck.
Well, if that's true, then what are we doing here in a whaleboat without any food and hardly any water?
Just sealed over after something. You couldn't get the launch clear. You murdered. Throw the whole ship company. And then... I'm dying, too. Well, I'm putting a curse on you. On both of you. A curse that will follow you and just... And
God! Josh!
Good, yes.
He's dead.
Okay. Heave him over the side.
What? We can't do that, Captain. That's tough.
What do you want to do? Keep him here? I said heave him over.
Listen, Captain. He was my pal. We shipped together for years.
You bloody fool, look over there. You see that black cloud? There's a squall coming. What chance do you think we'll have of living through it unless we light the ship?
He's right, man. It is a squall, and it's... And look. Look, they're running ahead of it. A sail, a ship.
A ship. We're... You're right. It is a ship. The ship coming this way. We're saved. We're saved.
Signal for them, Benson. Wave to him.
Ahoy there! Ahoy!
Wait a minute. Before they get here, let's get something straight. What Josh said about me wrecking the Mary Kay. He was out of his head, see? Out of his head?
Delirious. If you don't think so, well, I'd just as soon they found three dead men here as one.
You mean it? What do you say for that?
Ain't that near? Hey, was your suit in there was something funny about that ship.
Funny? Funny how?
Look at the way she's laughing, falling off.
Right, that's so. But there was no one at the helm.
But at least you can see him.
But can you see anyone else? Any crew?
Listen, getting aboard her is our one chance. Put out those oars and start rowing.
Aye, aye.
Come on, the oars, go.
Thinking? Brandon,
I doubt it.
He don't lie as if he was waterlogged.
What about a plague, sir? The whole crew dying off.
It might be. Look in this cabin here.
Looks like it must have been the captain.
Ah, yes. Everything's shipshape here, too. Bunk made up. Hey, what's that? There, against the wall.
The sea chest. Old.
That chest was old before you were born. Look at the ironwork. The rust on it.
What do you suppose is in it?
Well, now we'll soon see.
Holy jumping the artifact.
Gold. Bars of it. Jewels. Pearls as big as marble.
Pirate treasure. Maybe old Spanish treasure. Look at it! Look at it! We're rich! We're rich!
I'm going above and help those! Hey! Hey! Down below! Hurry!
This can't leave who he is. Where's he?
Down in the captain's cabin, a big chest full of gold and jewels and treasure.
That's so.
Don't you understand? We're rich! Rich!
Uh-huh.
Dan, what is it?
We don't know. It means that... Look! Christ up here. Captain.
Okay. I don't know what's come over you, but Captain Price, you come up sometime for a minute?
Aye, coming up. Well, so you don't like this ship, eh, Ben? Did he tell you what we found?
He told me, and it doesn't make me like it any better.
What do you mean?
You've been to sea for too many years, Captain. In fact, I have. But have you ever heard of anything like this happening before?
Like what?
Then we'll get rich, drift around for a day and a night, and out from boat, run into a ship without anyone on it, and then discover it's got treasure aboard.
Hey, what are you driving at? It happened, didn't it?
Did it? A couple of minutes ago, I saw Jake do something up the port bow there.
Saw something? What?
It was too dark to be sure. But it looked to me like a whale boat with five men in it. And somehow, I got the feeling that those five men were us.
What?
Yes, Tom. I don't think we're really here on board this ship at all. We only think we are. We're really still out there, tossing around in the whale boat. At least, our bodies are. I mean, I got a hunch that we're all dead.
Buy Carter's Little Liver Pills. They do the work of Calanol, but have no calomel in them. For they are simple pills made of vegetable drugs. They wake up the flow of one of our most vital digestive juices. When this vital juice flows at the rate of 2 pints a day, it helps to digest our food and bring back the glorious feeling that goes with regularity. Then most folks feel like happy days are here again. But be sure you get the genuine Carter's Little Liver Pills.
Well, you want to go back to sea again on the death ship? Very well. But if our course from now on is one that's never been sailed before, don't blame me. Just a moment later now. The three men are still standing in the stern of the death ship. It scuds north through the darkness. Old Train at the helm, Captain Pike, Tom Fenton, staring at it.
Dead? You think we're all dead? Boy, I tell it's a talker. None of us stop figuring out how much that treasure's worth because he'll never spend it. Because we're all ghosts.
Ben, why don't you go below and lie down for a while? I'll take the wheel.
All right. It makes you sneak and you can let the things about this whole business. It just doesn't make no sense.
Like what?
We still don't know why this ship was abandoned, what happened to the crew doing, and we don't know what killed the men we found left to the wheel.
Well, no, we don't.
Captain Pike, just come to us. The logbook.
Hey.
Wouldn't that make a fellow something?
You're right. Finding that treasure gets me so head up for never thought of this. Now, we'll go down and read it right now. Sure you don't want Benson to take the wheel, Ben?
No, Captain. I'll finish up this trick. You can take over at this place.
Okay. Come on, Benson. All right. Go look for the logbook and see
if... Oh, they sinking Chris, eh? Well, we'll see. Find out anything from the log?
Sure did. What a yarn.
I'm listening. Finish.
Well, it says the big ship here belongs to a man named Talbot, a yachtsman. He was snooping around a bookshop one day, and he came across an old book written by a don, a Spaniard, a couple of hundred years ago. It was all about a galleon, a treasure ship that went down around these parts.
Storm?
Partly. Talbot fitted out this ship, came down here to look for the treasure. Sounded all right, but as soon as they started home, funny things began to happen. See, the crew tried to break in and get Talbot's guns, and he had to shoot him. He shot another one when the guy went for him with a marlin spike. Then he realized he'd have to do something drastic. So he and his mate dumped the last five men into the whaleboat and set them adrift. That left just the two of them, Talbot and the mate.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the last entry was made day before yesterday. At least it's the beginning of an entry, but it trails off into a flat.
Mm-hmm. Sure, Talbot. It must be him who leaped on last to the wheel. But we still don't know who or what killed the mate.
No. No, we don't. Hey, listen, Ben. Do you really think there's anything to this first business?
Gold is always a curse, Tom. You know what I would do if I could, Tom? I would take that fish and twist it right over the side.
Well, you would, eh? Over my dead body.
Oh, hello, Captain. I got it. Didn't see you coming.
That gold's gonna make me a rich man.
Well, make you a rich man?
Well, all of us, Ben, all of us. That is, as soon as we get home.
Yes, sir.
Bring him right along, ain't he? Well, I think she could stand some more sail. Okay, come on up here.
All right,
Captain. Yes, sir. Let's go up. Put on more sail. I'll give you a hand with it.
Up we go, Captain. More sail.
Shore is full of night. At this ship, we ought to raise land by morning.
Easy. Easy.
What do you mean, maybe? Hey, what was that?
Sounds like curses. Captain Frank! Captain Frank, was that
close? Aye, it was. This is putting on the rat line. Went over the side.
This is putting?
Aye. Too much rum, I guess.
Well, I'll put her about to see if we can't get him up.
Hold your course. We'll never be able to find him at night.
Captain Frank!
Hold your course, I said. I'm going below.
Caught you. Overboard. That's
a striking. That wasn't why he fell. Did you see the butt of Pike's gun? There was blood on it. He struck him.
What? You mean, killed him? Pike?
He said almost into the surprise. Has he forgotten what last said before he died? That he left the marriage case on purpose?
I had forgotten. But if that's so, if he killed Cordy Murdoch,
then that's what he meant when he said he was going to be rich. Tom, we're going to be next.
Yeah? The heck we are. Hold the wheel while I get a marlin spike. Then when he comes back on deck, I'll jump him.
Jump him, eh? You know what that is, Captain Benson?
Mutiny, you
murder. That's how I am, Benson. I ought to kill both of you for what you're doing, conspiring against me. But I ain't going to make the same mistake Talbot made, kid. One man can't handle this ship, but two can. Oh.
Ben! You killed Ben, you...
That's how you, Benson. Yeah, I killed him. He was old, not as strong as you. Wouldn't have been as much use to me
you.
If I could stay in the wheel. And all that cost...
Due
fired, Benson?
No.
That's good. Won't be long now. Almost three bells. Sun will be coming up in a minute. When it does, I got a hunch we'll get a landfall.
And then?
What do you think?
I don't think. I know. You'll stay with me. Take her in by yourself.
Smart boy, Benson. That's just what I'm going to do. The Dons couldn't get the gold home, neither could Talbot, but I can and I'm going to. Look, there's the sun. And the head off there off the port ball, land.
Yeah, land.
Okay, Benson. Ready? Hey, what are you laughing at?
You. Go ahead and shoot. You think you can hurt me? You can't.
I can't.
Have you forgotten that whaleboat with the five men in it that Ben saw last night? The five men he said were us? Have you forgotten what he said that meant? We're sailing due north. The sun should be rising on the starboard side in the east, shouldn't it? But it's not. It's coming out to larboard in the west.
Sun rising in the west? Why, it can't be. And still it is.
And that land ahead there, it's not the coast. Don't you recognize it? It's Skeleton Key where you wrecked the Mary Kay. There's what's left of it. Now, do you understand? You're dead. You've been dead for 2 days. Dead and doomed to sail a death ship in a circle through all eternity.
No! No, we missed it!
I'm going to come up. It's dark. And it looks like the same shark that followed us all day yesterday.
Yeah. Well, that was smart work, Sam. I thought I saw you move once or twice. I had a hunch you weren't dead.
Well, since dead? Aren't we both dead?
Heck no. Does that slug through your shoulder feel as if you were?
Well, no, but... What you just said to Pike?
A trick, Sergeant. Get his gun.
Trick? There ain't no trick about the sun. It is rising in the west instead of the east.
No, it's not, Sam. As soon as I saw it, the whole thing came to me. You remember that body we found lashed to the wheel? The mate? You know what killed him?
Hmm?
Lightning.
Lightning?
Yeah. Struck by lightning during the storm when the Mary Kay went down. Besides killing him, it polarized the compass. Reverse it so that the needle pointed south instead of north. That's why it looked like the sun was coming up on the wrong side. That's why we ended back here at Skeleton Key again. We were sailing south all the time instead of north.
Well,
and you know who they were. The men Talbot and his mate set adrift so they wouldn't have to share the treasure with us. You know what we're going to do? We're going to pick them up. And get him to help us sail this ship home.
And the treasure?
You said you didn't want any part of it. Well, I don't either. They found it. Let them divvy it up. But us, we found this ship,
didn't we? It's great. Damn it.
It's ours now. Ours to do anything we like with. We're our own boss from here on in, Ben. And what more can a man want?
Nothing, Tom. Nothing in the world.
And that was the story of the death ship. The ship that sailed the Caribbean with a treasure aboard her and a dead man at the helm. Pleasant little tale, wasn't it? Did it have enough corpses and sudden death in it to sit to? Oh, it didn't. Some people are never satisfied.
It's a good thing they're not, Raymond, or there wouldn't have been any progress.
Oh, you mean we'd have to get along without such things as the telephone, the airplane,
the electric light, the radio,
and Carter's little Liverpool.
Heaven forbid.
Yes, Raymond, scores of people would hate to be without Carter's little Liverpool. Because they've learned that a mean, cranky, sour disposition due to irregularity often takes a decided change for the better.
Soon after they try, these simple little pills made of vegetable brush.
Yes. I'll be sure to mention that Carter's little liver pills do this by increasing the flow of a very important digestive juice.
That's right, folks. And the name, Carter's Little Liver Pills, tells us where that vital juice comes from.
So next time you don't feel good, try Carter's Little Liver Pills.
And see if you don't agree that they're the best friends to your sunny disposition. 25 cents at all drugstores.
This is Raymond again, your host, getting ready to close that door to the inner sanctum and say goodnight until next week, when our guest will once again be Paul Lucas. I hope you enjoyed our little story and that you got its moral. What moral?
Oh, it
had one, all right. All our stories have. Dead men tell no tales, except on the inner sanctum. So, next Sunday night, we'll overcome the hot weather, invite your friends in for a chilling evening, and listen to Inner Sanctum Mystery. However, if you just can't wait till the coming Sunday for our next one, satisfy your craving for a good murder story by reading this month's Inner Sanctum Mystery novel, I'll Eat You Last, by H.C. Brendon. Good night. Sweet dreams. Featured in tonight's cast were Arthur Vinton as Captain Pike, Byron McCormick as Tom, and Gilbert Mack as Fred. Original music by Lou White. Inner Sanctum Mysteries will be on the air again next Sunday evening, same station, same time, when we will again have the honor of bringing you the popular and gifted star of stage, screen, and radio, Mr. Paul Lucas. Be sure to listen in. This is Ed Hurley reminding you, when you don't feel good, try Carter's Little Liver Pills.